People had celebrated him as a god because his art, they said, was magical. Sweeter to them than the soft spring rains that blew off the lilac mountains. Secret as the wind whispering through the olives, Eurydice is some bride. He made a caressing music out of the vows of her name. All that he ever wanted was to see that ragtag minstrel band. Those merry dancers with whom he strolled at the green earth's invitation, their ranks swelling at each crossroad. How young they were who crowned him king of the carnival, and the news raced ahead of that as his passing trees broke into blossom out of season. Nightingales and owls perched on his shoulders, and down the winding country roads, processions of wild beasts, great spotted cats, weasels, and wolves tagged meekly at his heels, tamed by his song. Need. that one reprieve from Hades grants him all. Would he rejoice again to see the dark Lord shed a cold permissivity? Not look behind, nor could he guess how distantly she trailed. That was the law, senseless and cruel, but still imposing separate silences on two who struggled up the fetid slope, gasping for breath through swirls of sulfur clouds that parted to reveal in losing light covens of harpies roosting on the walls. And smothering on the rocks to ruin course ahead. Fires that seemed to wake with writhing arms. At the blackened gate, a single step removed from sunlight. Bird calls and the heady air. He waited for her to join him and to catch his hand, perhaps to murmur the last impetuous redemptive word. Instead, he heard her shrill, inhuman wail, a tongue echo locked into his ears, a cry of souls unseen. Having been touched by evil past forgiveness. Yes, he had turned as anybody would, as the ravaged face of all farewells, and the blank pennies of defeated eyes. As he sat in the dark, in the shuttered house, Orpheus heard the women hooting in the street. Against him, blaming him for their sister's loss. Apollo's priceless gift lay dusty at his feet, so much a part of him he won. The strings did not crack for grief. How could he deny that frenzied mob not to be assuaged except by blood?
Thank you. Thank you.